I'm working with a new real estate investor and she's doing great. She's gonna be a total rock star. But when she told me that she just walked away from a seller finance deal because they wanted a balloon payment, I was like, what? Then I caught myself. It's cool, baby steps. We're not that far along in her training yet, but did you know you can get stinking rich financing property with balloon payments? Well, I'm gonna show you how. Let's go. Hi, my name is Matt Terrio, CEO of Epic Real Estate, where we show people how to invest in real estate so they can escape the daily grind and retire early. And one of the ways we speed that up is by using more of our mind than our money with creative real estate investing. And last week, a new client of mine, as we were debriefing after an appointment she had just had, she told me that she met with a motivated seller, an older gentleman, and she asked him if he could carry back financing for her. And he agreed. And she proposed a small down payment, of which he didn't object to, but it was the 30-year amortized carryback he didn't like. In fact, his exact words were, "I'll be dead by then." Now, she's still very new and she didn't see a solution, so she left and just said she would follow up. And so I asked her, what did he want the term to be? She said she didn't ask, but then she explained it had to be a 30-year amortized loan in order for the property to produce a positive cash flow. So amortization is the reduction of a loan value over a set period of time. If you could pay off a loan over 30 years, you'd most commonly pay it in equal monthly payments. And if you reduced the term of the loan to 15 years, that monthly payment would have to be much higher since you only have 15 years to pay it. And this was her concern. That higher payment would amount to more than what the property would produce in rent. Therefore, the property would produce a negative monthly cash flow. Under conventional financing with a bank, she would be correct. But we're dealing directly with the seller, of which enables us to get creative with the financing. So I went on to explain it's possible to get the payment of a 30-year amortized loan with a 15-year or a 10-year or even a 5-year term. And you can do that with a balloon payment. A balloon payment, it's a final payment that is much larger than any earlier payment made on a debt. Typically, it would equate to the outstanding balance to be paid at the end of the loan term. So she understood that, but her next question was, and I get this almost every time someone hears the word balloon payment for the first time, where am I going to come up with all that money in 5 years? Well, it's actually pretty easy. And I'll give you multiple places to where you can get the money in just a second. But this is how you get stinking rich with balloon payments. And I'll use her deal as an example. First, understand that the objective to real estate investing is to not necessarily own it, but to control and profit from it. By accepting a seller's terms with a 5-year balloon, you'd profit monthly per the positive cash flow. You'd also pay down some of the loan, the amortization, which I consider profit too. You'd also get the tax breaks from the property, and there's a decent chance you'd see some appreciation as well. Mission one, accomplished. Multiple streams of profit achieved over the 5 years. Mission two, control. It was Nelson Rockefeller who famously said, "The secret to success is to own nothing, but to control everything." In this instance, she'd be named on title of the property, but more importantly, she'd control it had she accepted a balloon payment. And as John F. Kennedy famously said, a rising tide lifts all boats. Having a balloon payment in your creative financing toolbox enables you to get control of a lot of boats. The more you control, the greater you do when the tide rises. That's how people get stinking rich with real estate. They one, control a lot, two, profit a lot while they do, and three, when that tide rises, their wealth grows exponentially. Now, regarding profit and control, most people understand that, and so does my client. But to address her concern, what do you do when the balloon payment comes due? Well, let's take a look at all of the options a creative real estate investor has at their disposal when balloon payments are involved. And I came up with 6 of them. But there's more, I'm sure. You see, you're only limited by your own creativity. So number one, the worst case scenario. In 5 years, you gotta give the property back to the seller. Realize that there's no default jail, and unless you have a super sophisticated seller, the amount carried back by the seller is a non-recourse loan. It won't impact your credit score. Now, I wouldn't consider this a win. Nobody feels good about doing this, but I wouldn't consider it a loss either. You profited from the property for 5 years. The seller received a down payment and monthly payments for 5 years. It wasn't a waste of time. And actually, even if the seller doesn't see it this way, you are doing them a favor. Because when they get the property back, they get to sell it all over again, and likely for a higher price. And that dynamic should give you some insight as to why banks are in the business that they're in. They make money by originating loans, and they make money when their borrowers default on those loans. Number two, refinance. After up to 5 years of property performance, and you don't have to wait 5 years, replacing the seller's loan with a conventional loan or a private loan will typically be easier than a new purchase loan. The property will have a track record, some equity per the down payment and monthly payments, and whatever appreciation you experienced along the way. Number three, sell. I mean, you likely negotiated a discount purchase price up front. You likely paid some sort of down payment, and you made monthly payments along the way, and there's a better than average chance you also experienced some appreciation. You should have some equity, maybe a lot of it. And selling the property, it's a very viable solution to the balloon payment, not to mention a nice chunk of cash for you in your pocket. Number four, portfolio management. If this were the only deal you ever did and you weren't already wealthy, you might be limited to the first three options. But a lot can happen in 5 years. For example, you do more deals, you buy more property, you build a portfolio. When you have a portfolio, your options are essentially endless. It's easier to manage the finances on a portfolio of properties that you purchased at a discount and are producing profits than it is to find new discounted properties that produce profits. Here's what I mean. You could refinance a different property in your portfolio to pull out the cash to pay the balloon payment. You could sell a different property in your portfolio to create the cash to pay the balloon payment. Or something I do with all of my seller finance properties is insert a substitution of collateral clause in the loan documents. And that allows me to move property A's debt to property B's, making property A a free and clear property, of which would make it very easy for me to refinance or sell property A to pay off a balloon payment of property C or D or E. So when considering a balloon payment for one of your seller finance deals, don't view it in a vacuum. It's just one deal of the many you're gonna do over the loan term. And that brings me to the next option. You're likely flipping properties too. Don't discount the probability that you'll have accumulated some cash along the way. I mean, that's why we're in real estate, right? To make some money? When you're super concerned with a balloon payment 5 years from now, what you're actually doing is selling yourself short, assuming you'll be in the same position you're in right now. Don't do that. You're better than that. Number five, pay it. You could just pay the balloon payment when it's due. Or number six, pay it off early. You see, my strategy for all of my seller finance properties is to set a reminder every 6 months to give the seller a call. And that conversation sounds something like this.
Mr. Seller, it's Matt, and I've got another property I'm ready to purchase. I've been making my $300 payments to you each month, and I still owe you about $50,000. Now, before I buy this other property, I just thought I'd call you first and offer to settle our balance for $40,000 instead of giving it to the seller for his property. Would you like to do that?
And just be quiet and wait for the answer. If they say yes, I just got an additional $10,000 discount off whatever discount I originally negotiated. If they say no, I say, okay, no problem, and I keep making my payments. And then I'll call them back in 6 months when my reminder goes off again, and I'll have a similar conversation. I get these early payoff proposals accepted within 3 years about 70% of the time, because the seller typically is emotionally less attached to the property later on, and they get tired of receiving the small monthly payments and either need or have plans for a big chunk of cash, even if the payoff is at a discount. In my world, a fast nickel beats a slow dime, and oftentimes in the seller's world too. So embrace the balloon payment. No need to be afraid. That's a poverty mindset to be so. You're a creative rock star real estate investor. A balloon payment, it's a big nothing burger of a challenge for someone like you. So what did you find most valuable? Let me know below. And who do you know that needs to see this? When their name comes to mind, please share it with them. Oh, and if you're already subscribed, I pulled this video out special for you to watch next. Otherwise, I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching. Take care.